Welcome to the channel, friends. So today I have a Honda HSS snowblower video. I have about 6 to 7 inches of heavy, wet, clumpy snow that I just got here overnight in southern New Hampshire. And as you can see, it's perfect snowball material and it makes a nice dense snowball. So that's what I'm contending with today. It's about 6-7 inches here and there. And this is super heavy stuff, perfect for the trial of my custom fabricated chute deflector. I made this out of HDPE. My original design was out of Teflon, but I went ahead and made it better this time around. I shortened the opening height-wise and I widened it at the base. So this chute here has the factory collar removed. I went ahead and cut that right out and ground away the welds. So this essentially will keep all the discharge contained to the chute, and you won't have any blow by that occurs when you have the chute rotated in this direction or backwards. It also will keep the hood clean and the auger housing clean. So it's just gonna contain everything to the chute and give you a better kind of cleaner pattern, stream of discharge, I should say, for the machine. So I'm gonna put it through the paces today and give it a run. And I know it's gonna perform well because my previous design performed well and did not clog. So this is gonna be a great performance test. So let me get to it, start the machine up, warm it up, and then I'll go ahead and get snow blowing.
All right, guys, so there it is. I did the whole driveway. This driveway is about 900 feet long. That was heavy snow, as you can see here. It's still stuck to the auger itself. And the chute deflector worked really well. I'm really happy with the performance. And as you can see here, there is no buildup on the top of the machine. Nothing on the hood and nothing on the auger housing. So this performed really well. I'm really happy with the size of the cutout because it does not let too much blow by through. As you can see here, there is some buildup on the light, but it's very minimal. You have to have some kind of opening so it prevents it from clogging with the heavy super wet stuff. So really happy with the way it performed. I normally use the plow for the driveway since I have an ATV with a plow. My XP1000 does a great job. It's really fun plowing the driveway with the ATV. The plow, now that I have the poly edge on it, so I took out the steel edge and I put a poly edge, it works really well because it's taller and it cleans up the driveway better, I feel, than the snowblower. But there's less input needed with the plow versus the snowblower to keep the height control correct and keep everything kind of, the thing floating correctly, I guess you could say. It takes a lot of input from you with the height control lever, which is right here. But once you get used to it, it's fine. The machine performs extremely well. I'm just really kind of really nitpicking it, but really happy with the way the Honda performs, especially now that I have the chute deflector that I made. So really happy overall with the machine. This is the first time I've had it out this year. I normally will take care of the smaller stuff with the plow. Only when I get the heavy, tall stuff, I use a snowblower because the plow just takes a lot less time. Usually it will take me about half an hour to do this driveway, believe it or not. With a snowblower, it takes about 45 minutes or so, or to an hour, depending on how tall the snow is. But there it is, guys, a performance test of the chute deflector and showing it in different kind of situations. I did the main part of the driveway, then I did the front of the driveway, end of driveway area, and then I went ahead and went up the landing here, up the hill, and took care of the landing with the stairs and everything. So now I need to just go ahead and take care of the snow on the stairs. So as you can see, the vehicles are all cleaned off now. I just need to finish up some work here and I'll be good to go. So I really hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you have any questions or comments, please place them right down below. And if you have not subscribed to the channel already, please go ahead and do so. I want to thank you guys for watching and I'll see you on the next video.